Hey friends, so I am super excited to report that last Friday I got my second shot of the Pfizer vaccine, which means that a week from Friday I will be fully immunized, which is an enormous weight off my shoulder. Now, I'm not going to stop wearing my mask anytime soon. Why? Well, come walk with me and I'll explain. Drex here from Drex Factor Poi, sharing with you the love of poi spinning and flow arts, and today we are going to, as occasionally happens on this channel, talk about some of the more macro issues in the world, because they do impact flow artists too. Before we dive in, I just want to give a quick shout out to the friends of the channel.
Big thanks to Dark Monk, Flow DNA, Flow Fests, Flow Toys, Juggling Calling, Pyroterra Light Toys, Spinballs, and Ultrapoi for helping to make the videos on this channel possible. You can learn more about all these amazing companies and the work that they're doing to support flow artists like yourself by checking out the links that I've got down in the description of this video.
So I'm actually going to start this off with a little bit of a mea culpa. Namely because when we first learned that the coronavirus, COVID-19, was going to be a thing roughly a year and a half ago, I was definitely one of those people that was skeptical. I had a lot of friends who were deeply concerned about what was going to happen and, you know, what would the impact be to our culture if the COVID-19 virus made its way all around the world and became a big deal. And I told many, many of them that I believed that the concern was overwrought, that the fatality rates were low enough that it didn't really matter. And that in the end, it would turn out to be a blip, much like SARS and MERS both were earlier in the 21st century. And I was so wrong, and I apologize to all of the friends out there that I tried to convince that, you know, the epidemic was not going to be that bad, that the pandemic was going to turn out to be overblown and overhyped, and that we would be back to normal life by the summer. Yeah. I think it's helpful from time to time to admit it when you do make mistakes like that, especially when they have a cost on the people around you. And I, for one, am really, really sorry that I held on to those views probably far longer than I should have. But I also appreciate the fact that, you know, I can be in a place where I can look at the ways I've made those mistakes in the past and be like, you know what? Yeah, that was really boneheaded of me, and I'm sorry. So many of you will know that I have been very, very diligent in my mask wearing for all of the past year. One of the biggest reasons being that once it became clear that COVID-19 was going to be a big deal, quite frankly, I got a little worried. You know, it's one of those things that I live on the outskirts of a major American city, and I go into that city on a semi-regular basis. So I basically shut down for, I would say, probably 3 months, from about March to June of last year, and basically ceased having contact with the outside world, aside from, you know, going grocery shopping and having video calls with people and everything. No small part of this stemmed from the fact that right as quarantine was starting, a very good friend of mine came down with COVID-19, and she is still dealing with the side effects of this in terms of her lung capacity. She used to run regularly before she got infected, and she no longer really can in the same way that she did before. It's really been kind of tragic to watch, because she's also an amazing singer, and I've seen her struggle with some stuff that used to be quite easy for her before she got sick. And I feel real bad for her, and quite frankly, you know, making sure that I was following proper safety protocols was one of those ways that I felt like I could, you know, take a look at what had happened to her and kind of honor her experience. To say nothing of the fact that I didn't want it to happen to me, too. And because the data was really slow coming in those first few months, I was extremely paranoid about getting sick. So it would be that thing that, you know, I wouldn't come within 10 to 12 feet of people that I would encounter outside. And people really, really, really had to convince me that they had been safe if I were to have any close or indoor contact with them whatsoever. In fact, for most of the past year, I've really only had indoor face-to-face contact with maybe 3 people total. It's been a little lonely, I will admit, but at the same time, you know, it also is one of those things that, you know, felt and continues to feel like something that was a smart move on my part in terms of making sure that I kept my risk factors as low as possible. So now that I am vaccinated, albeit not fully vaccinated because it is going to take another week for those antibodies to fully kick in, what exactly does that spell for my current risk factors? Well, here's what I've been able to glean from the data. So from what I can tell, having contact with other vaccinated individuals is like pretty much about as safe as you're going to get in terms of contact with other people at this point. Especially if it's outdoors, there is basically no need to worry. As for indoors, well, you know, again, contact with other vaccinated people should be pretty much fine. As for contact with unvaccinated individuals, well, that gets a little tricky. And from what I understand, while I'm pretty well protected at this point, or at least I will be in another week and everything, it's not 100%. No vaccine is. So having contact with unvaccinated people, you know, whether it be indoors or outdoors, is still kind of rolling the dice a little bit. It's definitely a little bit safer outdoors, but the indoor thing, especially in a closed area, that's kind of rolling the dice. But here's the thing. I got to admit that when it comes right down to it, only part of this is about the data for me, partially because we're still getting it. Like, you know, it seems like there's a new study every couple weeks, every couple months, that rewrites at least some of what we think we knew. And especially because this level of mass vaccination happening this quickly is kind of unprecedented in human history. So we're bound to be getting more information on what does and doesn't work in the coming months. And in the meantime, I think it doesn't hurt to stay cautious, you know? You know, I'm not going to have a lot of reasons to regret it if I'm overly cautious, but I can tell you for sure that if I'm not overly cautious and I do wind up getting COVID, I'm probably going to have a lot of reasons to have regret that choice. Which I am sure is going to come as a rather bitter pill for many people who watch this channel on a regular basis. One of the most common things that happens every time I post a new Flow video is there will be someone in the comments that will try to convince me to stop wearing a mask. They'll either say, well, you're not actually around anybody, or, oh, I wish I could see your smile instead. It's basically just different variations on the same theme. Namely, that people are trying to talk me out of wearing a mask in various different fashions. Now, here's the thing. We could argue back and forth about the data all day, and there's all kinds of weird BS that people have dreamed up to try and talk me out of this, telling me that, you know, I'm not getting enough oxygen through the mask or what have you, which I've been running in this mask now for over a year, and I've never had a problem. I don't know what you think you're telling me about oxygen use there. But when it comes right down to it, I have been wearing a mask and I will continue to wear a mask because that is what is comfortable for me. Like, that is where I am comfortable basically setting my risk factors with people. And yes, there are some people that I know that I'm probably not going to wear a mask around, A, because I know they're vaccinated, and B, I know what risk factors they themselves have exposed themselves to. And when I encounter people that I don't know that are not wearing masks, I'm probably going to make sure that I don't come within about 6 to 10 feet of them, just because that's what I'm comfortable with. Now, I think that this actually goes to the heart of why my mask wearing has been such an issue for so many people. It communicates something right away, namely that I am setting a boundary. It means that instantly people know that there are certain things that I'm going to be comfortable with and certain things that I am not going to be comfortable with. And really at the core of every single person who's left one of those comments on my Flow videos is this central idea that they want to be able to set where my boundary is for me. Guess what? I'm not okay with that. If your boundaries are in a space where you don't want to wear a mask, well, I mean, that's your call. I personally think that it's a little reckless, but you know what? It's not up to me what you do with your body. Also, side note, how weird is it that so many people that claim to be in the personal autonomy crowd are now trying to convince people not to wear masks? Like, your issue clearly isn't personal autonomy here. It's how people are treating their autonomy in relationship to yours. There's a very odd phenomenon that happens when people make choices about their bodies and their autonomy, where if they see other people making different choices, that sometimes comes off as a threat to them. And especially if you're somebody who, say, has a worldwide following on multiple social media platforms and you're making a choice that's different, then it makes that choice credible, it makes that choice respectable, which was always the point. Part of why I wear a mask is because I want to normalize that for other people. And you know what? When you normalize people setting boundaries like this, there's a lot of people that are not going to be okay with that. And you know what? I don't care if they're not okay with it, because you know what? This is where my comfort level is at, and it's going to continue to stay that way. Y'all can deal with it. And when will that change? I have no idea. A lot is going to depend upon, like, the rates at which people get vaccinated, and quite frankly, whether we ever have a moment where people kind of chill out a little bit and are just kind of like, I see the choice that you're making and I respect you for it. In the meantime, though, yeah, the mask ain't going anywhere anytime soon. That's how it goes. And if you likewise are in a place where your comfort zone is to keep on wearing a mask, even and especially after you get vaccinated, don't let anybody make you feel bad about it. You know what? You're making the best choice that you think you can for your health. And when it comes right down to it, you're the person that gets to make that choice for you, no one else. And yeah, there's definitely a little, you know, subject there in terms of how people handle the personal autonomy of people on the internet and the complicatedness of parasocial relationships, but that's going to be a topic for another video. And goodness, this is another one of those videos where I can't wait to see what the comments section is going to be like. But hey, in the meantime, if you got anything out of this video, please make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe to help other people find it, and of course, to help my channel grow. And a huge thank you, because this video would not be possible without the kind contributions of these amazing people right here. These are my Flow patrons over on Patreon, and they, along with the wonderful people that I've got listed down in the description, help to make this video and all the videos on this channel possible. If you would like to sign up to support the work that I'm doing, bringing the love of poi spinning and flow arts to the wider world and helping people learn to be creative with their brains and their bodies, you can do so by heading on over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and signing up. There you can get early access to all of my content, as well as they say and what topics I tackle in the future. Plus which, some great extras and behind the scenes content as well. So, go check that out. Please and thank you. Hey, if you'd like to check out some more video essays that I have done on various topics, I'm going to include a link to a playlist of them down in the description, as well as up here on the screen if you happen to be watching on YouTube. Is there a topic you'd like to see me tackle? Let me know in the comments. Sometimes I have thoughts on things and sometimes I don't. We'll see which one that I happen to be on your particular topic. In the meantime, please make sure to get outside and flow, because it is good for you, and I will see you with a new video on Wednesday. Thanks so much, and have a good one. Peace.